So now that you know how to set the viewport meta, let's poke around in the developer tools to see what we need to do to fix this page. Now, the biggest problem here is that the page has a fixed column width. If I resize the window, you'll notice the column of text doesn't actually change size, just margin position. As we mouse around the elements inside the DevTools, we can pretty quickly find the first offending element. This page element here actually has a width set on it. Let's disable that and see what happens. Well, it certainly changed things, but I don't think it actually improved things very much. Let's keep digging inside the content and see what we can find. This wrapper element has a width of 100% already, which is good. It means that it's not preventing us from resizing. But this content element does have a width set in pixels. Let's disable that. Now as we resize the page, our content is fine, but the sidebar is appearing and disappearing. Sure enough, it has a width set. If we set its width as a percentage also, now we're resizing a little bit better. So now let's go back up to the page and let's try giving it a width, but let's give it a width in viewport units instead. Now our only remaining problem seems to be that the header is actually not resizing as we want it to. Let's go take a look at the header image again. The image has a max width set, but not just a width. So let's set its width. And now everything seems to be resizing well. Now, this isn't perfect, but all that I really wanted to get at was that as you try to transition pages from fixed layout to fluid layout, the core things to look for are fixed pixel sizes and lack of percentage resize.